Forever could never be long enough for me to feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see. But there's one thing left to do.
So Jess and I met on the 4th of August 2012.
Love has surely shifted.
We met in a good old-fashioned bar in Leeds, so Jess knew what to expect immediately because I managed to fashion together a few obstinate Yorkshire sentences to woo her into dancing with me, and then I embarrassed us both for a few hours. And then at the end of the night, I was grumpy when I couldn't get a taxi.
To feel like I am close enough to you.
Love is always wanting to say, have a good day, be safe, I love you, when leaving there. Love is going to sleep after an argument, because you're always sorry after a good night's sleep. Love is knowing to feed him at 12 o'clock on the dot, so you can trick him into shopping all afternoon. Love is challenging, perfect, imperfect, boring and thrilling. Love is finding your true love, best friend and other half in just one person. Love is home.
Say you will.
Say you will. Promise me you'll always be happy by my side. I promise to sing to you when all the music dies. And marry me today and every day. Marry me if I ever get the nerve. Say hello in this cafe. Say you will. Say you will. Marry me.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding and join me in welcoming Mr. and Mrs. Archer.
As long as stars are above you.
We knew we were onto a good thing because before we went to New York to visit James, we said to Joe, look after Jess for us, will you? And he said, always. I'll never forget that.
Follow their plan.
We would all agree that a man like Joe can never bag a girl like Jess through pure luck or his natural charm. So ladies and gentlemen, I'm about to reveal to you the secrets on how I coordinated the greatest love story ever told. As I present to you, Joe Archer and Curse of the She-Devils. The final chapter is blank. The future is still unwritten. But what we do know is that Joe and Jess are right for each other. If we could define what a soulmate is, I think we'd have a picture of these two with their perfect children.